Today, I want to talk about the kind of content you and I are consuming on the internet. Take the example of this TikTok versus YouTube controversy where you had Carrie Minati versus Amir Siddiqui. Just look at that body language. Look at the anger. Look at the angst. Why should we have this ma behen ki galis and have these kind of conversations all the way when your fans are watching? You are stars, you are content creators. Don't we bear that responsibility as content creators? As viewers and watchers of all of these videos that are on our timelines, as fans, are we somewhere disappointed? Are we failing ourselves? Do we ought to not question whether the kind of content that we are consuming today must really be out there? Think about that video of that woman who was out there in tattered clothes, and the next shot is of a man zipping up his pant. Or that TikTok video in which a boy is slapping his girlfriend because she no longer is interested in him, and normalizing the idea of slapping his girl. I understand that everybody is young and there is so much energy and we want to share all these feelings. And there is, of course, the desire to go out there and become the stars that these are. I mean, look at their following. Millions and millions and millions of followers and fans, and so much money riding on each one of them. Having said that, I wonder, what did really trigger the kind of conversation that happened between Carrie Minati and Amir Siddiqui? The way they were dissing each other, the use of the word beti, as if that is some sort of a gali that we need to normalize. But I do feel like asking, what is it in it that makes us consume such stuff and be okay with it? Why haven't any of us questioned the need for being so angry, so aggressive, so harsh, bad language, and also using words that sort of are cuss words which have gendered reasons, I mean gendered connotations? I feel, why haven't we questioned all this? Where is this coming from? The fact that today we are all having conversations about patriarchy, misogyny, feminism being questioned, homophobia, and just seeing that we are not able to accept genders as they are, people as they are. We are far from being inclusive. And when we see such content go out, should we not ask ourselves that, is this the society that we're trying to change? You know, somebody said this to me, social media is nothing but a reflection of the real society. But could that be a justification of the fact that today we have a patriarchal society? We continue to see oppression against women. We continue to see very male-dominated behavior. Why can't we use the internet as a tool to change that? Agar dekha jaye ki jitne inke fans the, Carrie Minati ke hain aur Amir Siddiqui ke, Faiz Siddiqui ke aur bahut sare jo TikTok aur YouTube stars hain unke, I think ki inko dekhte hue aisa nahi hame lagta ki kya ye aaj society mein kitna kuch change la sakte hain, par bilkul koshish nahi kar rahe. With power, fame and money, should we not expect them to have some responsibility? Responsibility is not about creating boring content. But agar unka itna influence hai, to kya counter speech, conversations that are feminist, conversations that are inclusive, conversations that consider gender equality as a basic theme, could these conversations not happen? How come they don't feel like creating that kind of content? I don't think that their fans, if they get to see one out of five pieces that they put out, that actually reminds them about their responsibility about society, genders, behavior, and also standing up and speaking out. I feel that as somebody who's a tracker of a lot of news that comes around women, I was very disappointed with the last 3-4 weeks. Is it time that we all, as not just as young people, but also as sort of self-correctors of each other, can we look at a way by we can collectively come and talk in a language which is at least inclusive? I really feel that we all need to start that dialogue and not end up creating a video like this after every single incident and asking, after that video, nothing happened. Banning cannot be the answer. We have to change as a society. We have to make an impact by saying, we will get together and raise voices against homophobia, against sexism, against misogyny. Only when we do that will we truly leverage the power of being who we are, these amazing content creators who today are truly empowered to speak a language, to speak about issues that can change and impact society.